Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be playing part two of the Hand of Merlin, and I was so impressed with this game I've decided I'm going to take you guys all the way to Jerusalem. So we have completed the first two cities and we are now in Al-Shana. Do is we are gonna make sure we cleanse the world of evil. So for those of you that haven't watched part one, this is a turn-based RPG where you've got three characters in your party, all with distinct abilities. So you've got the warrior, the ranger, and the mage, and you have a variety of human and abominations to fight. So the abominations being more powerful, so they have passive abilities that really stack up, so you want to wipe them out quickly. The red caps are sort of their basic soldiers, and their mandrakes explode upon impact, so you want to kill them with a ranged unit. What I love about this game is literally it's you know, the battle's just quick. You know, every playthrough's different in terms of the nodes that you go to, and more importantly, it's a lot of fun. We're a little bit far away to mark. My units are quite powerful now, as they're all level 5. We haven't been spotted yet, so when you do an ambush, you can advance. As soon as you hit one of the eyes, they have a chance of spotting you. What you want to do is creep up just enough to get ourselves set up and get a couple of pop shots off. I wanted them to do was to bunch up a little bit. Thank you. Warcry buffs your character. We've got a lot of resistance points on at the moment, so we're going to have to kill them eventually. Two cockatrices together are doing a lot of damage to me. Thankfully, they are poisoned as well. So we should have enough to slowly heal them. Us. I'm going to take a little bit of health damage moving through here, but I don't really have much choice because I need to strike and kill these two, so we should finish off the second one next turn. Stunned for a turn, which isn't helpful. But he's poisoned and vulnerable, so he's gonna pretty much be near death. Was definitely one of the tougher fights that I've had so far. that we should be able to get to. I'm going to go like that or something similar. Actually, we're going to cut down and go through the city of Astagora. Last one, we want any crazy plants on the loose. So we're gonna go to the village and stock up on some food. Thankfully, they've only got one cockatrice this time. As well. We should have time to hide, but later. It's worth noting the Thorn Toads have an attack that does 4 damage when you're in melee range if you hit it, so you want to keep your distance from them. So we want to engage it from about here. I see what you miss on a 90% chance. Down one to go. We should make pretty quick work of this guy. We'll take the treasury. Be a town in 2 moves. Sacrifice to pay. Go fed, watered, and plenty of gear. Can make our way to the city now. We're gonna go for the unusual temple. Thank you. gone from running out of food to picking up all the supplies now. Fire 3 stacks of bleeding, but also take health damage. It's a bit disappointing. Still, you win some, you lose some, as they say. Attack. Deal 2 damage to one of your allies, but apply plus 5 damage to their attack. That's useful, you've got a lot of armor. Intimidation didn't cure. Thank you. to really keep him at bay this time. Obviously Mandrakes explode, so we're not going to want to kill him, but what we can do is bash him away. Them into the enemy. Yeah, there you go. They've put horror down, so we'll take damage from moving, so I'm actually better off waiting for the next turn. I do not know what happened there, but did a lot of damage. God, that one's over. Didn't do that battle too well. The hero gained way too much damage. So we're going to have to protect him in the next city battle. So our Holy Grail has awoken. Okay, so you have to get close to the pylon to remove it. Okay, that makes sense. Say we didn't spawn in the greatest of places here. Probably why you want to kill the pylon quickly, because it's a summoner. Ugh. And it gives us a damage and a speed penalty. Thank you. Here die next turn, we need to freaking kill this thing. How did you miss from there? Like a pylon. Hero for destroying our first pylon. explain ourselves a wearing. So there we go, just the small leap to Jerusalem. Services if I wasn't broke. Suppliers now, so we may as well level up again. Give ourselves a super skill. Going to be the one for him. go. That one's got no cooldown, so we can actually attack twice now. Okay. Here we are then, corrupted city of Jerusalem. Three towers now, rendering power and repulsion. We are surrounded. Utilize that one next turn. We have to wait two turns anyway, so we may as well start chipping away these guys. Oh, we just miss, you know.
Yeah.
go.
Yeah.
Do a lot of empty terrain up there. So kind of did deliberately so we could give her a clear shot. She is dazed, however. But she may miss the shot. Mana's got to recharge. What I didn't want to do is poison my own unit. Pretty much killed everything around it, so two down and one to go. She's only got one stack of poison, but I will probably keep her far back as possible. And go charging in with we're doing this so we don't get overwhelmed with units. But we should be alright now. And almost exclusively keep her out the battlefield. Which... stay out of range for thick skin. Go. We are victorious and we have reclaimed Jerusalem.
Together we have succeeded. The Grail has achieved its purpose. It has healed the wounds in reality. This world is safe, and the Cataclysm will move on. I am proud of your accomplishment, but I can guide you no longer. Soon, I will be little more than a memory, a legend. The fate of this world is in your hands now. Out there, beyond the veil, infinity still awaits me. Even now, the Cataclysm is beginning to consume another world. But I am Merlin, and I will not yield.
Go 51 jumps, 19 battles, gained a ton of stuff, shows you all the things that we killed as well. That's quite a little neat little update there. So I'm gonna say it's an absolute fantastic game. So you know, now that you have completed a few things. You can inspect your heroes. Ranger and a mystic. Fairly similar to Morgan. Radar spells as well. So we've got two essence that we've gained from our quest. So we've added healing, the thunderbolts, warps. Halo spell that literally explodes the ground. It's gonna have to be Halo, isn't it? Runs as well, which is a good touch. To be honest, I just quite liked playing it on easy, just for the story. And now we've got a more powerful core. He can run, but it makes him harder to, I suppose, he gets into position quicker. I'll add the new ones just to see how they look. Definitely a Grail of Honor is better than the one of Fortitude. So go back in Camelot. Although the nodes are the same, you know, there's still tons of reasons to replay the game, as every single, you know, path's going to be different. So, you know, this time we're going to go through the Castle of Maidens. Every time you go there, it's a different experience, so. Gain some mana before we experience those. very valiantly to quiet our armor. But... no success for him. Definitely missed war cry. We haven't been spotted yet, so we can so it was weird going from a souped up hero back to a weakened hero. You definitely missed having the abilities that you had. Probably so then for boss fights, but some of those spells are pretty satisfying to use. I mean, we've pretty much shredded that mandrake. And they can really help turn the tide. units of mana here. So here we were at Castle of the Maidens. Now, aren't we? I mean, there's some fantastic lore that goes on in the game, so. Which you've already done, to be fair, we've. Unlocked everything we can in the core. I believe we can. Oh, we can upgrade literally every spell as well. That would be good for the last boss. We can teleport right to the pillars and drain them. Some modest upgrades. Monsters. save our halo for the end boss of this level. Asian, so he's not going to I was feeling confident, went for an attack there and he missed. Certainly didn't favour us on that turn. Take arm damage, so I might as well just fire.
Oh!
Oh, I knocked him too close to us. Damage be done. Might as well. Need any supplies? So it's really good, again, some really good detail on the environments, you know, village that's been infested by the abominations, you know, they've killed everyone and to have one right in front of us. Shredded's quite a powerful one to use. so we can feed the crows again. But again, different story this time. Straight into a trap. Just a few errands, but evasion, so you don't have to take a hit. Thank you. nice little manor upgrade there before we get to the city. Only three enemies. I thought I'd spoil the surprise. May have been a cover bomb, but that did a lot of damage. Unwatched. Okay. give our behemoth the halo. Worth using just for the flame effect. Behemoth, what behemoth? Absolutely annihilated it with those two spells. And that's the definite perk to playing again, you know, new characters, you know, upgraded spells, you know, get the hang of the mechanics and really take the plunge into. Playing different characters, playing it more difficult, you know. That's the real beauty of this game, there's a lot of replayability, even if there's only four areas. Halo still leaves a lasting impression on the battlefield. So, 100% huge fan of this game. I mean, since I reviewed it today, I've played over 4 hours of it. So, you know, really addictive. You know, no playthrough is the same. You know, every node I've gone through has had a different story. Recommend picking this one up tomorrow, guys. Fantastic game, and a big thank you to Versus Evil for providing me a copy for review. Anyway, guys, I hope you like this two-parter. Please like and subscribe for future videos.